We thank thee in the name of thy holy child, Jesus Christ, for thy word which endureth forever, the word which by the gospel is preached unto us. Grant unto me thy servant, that with all boldness, that I may speak thy word, by stretching forth thy hand to heal, that signs and wonders be done, in the name of thy holy child, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. From the book of Revelation, chapter 4, verse 11, it is written, thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. All things were created by God, and all things are and were created for His pleasure, and God is holy, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Without holiness, no man shall see God. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way. For there is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way which leadeth to destruction, and many there be therein. For straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth to life, and few there be that find it. For Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by him, for neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given above men whereby we must be saved. For how shall we escape if we neglect the great salvation? For he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. For God taketh no pleasure in the death of the wicked, for the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men have slackness, but is long suffering to There is joy in the presence of the angels of God in heaven over one sinner that repenteth, for God is willing for all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For it pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe, that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. But how then shall they call upon him of whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Now that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that Christ was buried, and that Christ rose from the dead the third day according to the scriptures, repent ye and believe the gospel. For he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. Repent, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And these are Christians, that ye might believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing ye might have life through his name. Yes, the Son, lest ye be angry and ye perish from the way when his wrath is kindled. But a little lesson for all they that put their trust in him. Of taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him, for it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. Repent ye and believe the gospel. For all flesh is as grass, and all the glory of heaven Yeah. Chevy white hast. No, no, baby red like crimson. They shall be as wool. For if any man come to Christ, Christ will in no wise cast him away. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. The Spirit and the bride say, come. Let him that heareth say, come. Whosoever is athirst, let him come. For whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely. Behold, now is the appointed time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. For thy pleasure they are and were created. For God hath created all things for his pleasure. And God taketh no pleasure in the death of the wicked. There is joy in the presence of the angels of God in heaven over one sinner that repented. For God is not willing for any to perish, but that all should come to repentance. For except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. Repent ye and believe the gospel. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief, and Jesus Christ the same, yesterday, today, and forever. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. And now I'm going to pray for each and every one of you that God would be merciful unto your souls as I pray for your salvation. Heavenly Father, in the name of thy holy child, Jesus Christ, I pray through all who have heard my voice for the salvation of their souls.